Hello everybody, it is your boy, Gyro the Console Scrub himself, and we are back with another quick commentary. We're going to be talking about some changes that are going to be happening to Battlefield 1. So the updates are going to start rolling out more frequently. They're going to be working on some stuff, a few things. Our hardcore servers are coming soon, so for any of you that are looking forward to hardcore in Battlefield 1, it is coming very soon. They're also going to be tweaking one of the maps. I forgot the map off the top of my head, but it's one that has the beached dreadnought and the train that spawns out. It's the map that has three flags. They're going to be increasing the flags from 3 to 5 and reducing the capture size of 2 of the flags on the map. Battlefest also starts November 16th with a big PTFO. Is what they are stating. It's going to be a week-long celebration for the Battlefield franchise and will be packed with new activities including login rewards, a live stream with news, and a unique battle pack revision, and also some community missions. And then they said that there's going to be more, but we'll just have to see. Probably on the live stream is whenever they are going to introduce the rest of the stuff that they didn't state in the little update on the Battlefield app and also at battlefield.com. Also, Fog of War, which is the custom games mode, is going to be coming very soon. It is going to be the first official custom game for Battlefield 1, and is going to premiere at Battlefest. It's a unique team deathmatch experience. You will be challenged by limited sight, as there will be thick-ass fog everywhere, and I don't know if I'm going to enjoy that all too much. I will definitely try it, but I'm just not a fan of the thick-ass fog. Maybe on TDM it won't be as bad, but on Conquest and certain maps, whenever the fog just doesn't go away forever, it becomes really annoying. So there are also going to be new updates coming this month also, so we will be getting the rent a server program hopefully, and also tweaks for the servers and matchmaking. I really wish that they would increase the time that you're allowed to quit out of a game after like Conquest, TDM, Rush, anything except for Operations. You have to make sure to quit out on console at least within, 5 to 10 seconds of the game being over and the final scoreboard coming up, because if not, you will be locked in that game. So please increase it for me. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed a few of these news and details. If you already knew about it, then I am sorry that I'm late to the party. But anyways, we'll see you with some videos, and next time, get crushed, bitch.